So, when his colleague failed to share the vision with him, this young man, what he did was moving away from the colleague. Because the colleague failed to share the dream with, to share the dream and the vision the friend had with him. So he moved away from him. So you also have to move away from dream paralyzers, vision paralyzers. Some people on earth, they will never believe what you want to do. They will never believe you. No amount of words that you can say that will make them believe you. So they will not believe you. But since you have known that they will not believe you, what we do is you will get off them. You will move away from them. Because when you move away from them, you will be able to make advancements. God will reveal himself more unto you. And then the dim light you think you have seen will be growing. Will be growing. Will be multiplying. So, to make the dim or the limited light that you have seen to grow, you have to move away from vision paralyzers or dream paralyzers. Number 9 point is, do not fight anyone. Avoid fight. No, when people are speaking harsh words against you, do not retaliate. Do not start fighting them. The Bible says believers should not fight. So you should not fight them. If you want the dim light that you have seen to be magnified, if they want to say you are a witch, that is why you have not procreated, you have not given birth for your husband, do not fight them. If they want to say you are this and that it is because you are this, that your husband's business is not progressing, do not fight them. If they want to say you are your wife or you are a sorcerer, and because of this, your church is not growing. You can see members leaving your church every day. Do not fight them. Do not fight. Under no circumstance must you fight. When you do not fight, that light will continue to grow. You can see the matches I ignite at the beginning of the sermon, that assuming I am fighting, when the match is on, the light will suddenly go off. But if I avoid fight and I concentrate on the matches, on how to get a candle to light, or how to get a lantern to light, or how to make use of the limited matches that I have ignited to grow big, maybe, and so on and so forth, you know, I cannot fight. And if I do not fight, the light will become big for my use. So when you avoid fight, you avoid so many things. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs that live before the fight becomes escalated. Number 10 point is, explore any opportunity that presents itself. Example is Joseph. Explore the opportunity presenting itself to you. There will always be opportunity. And that's where you are. Yes, you thought that things cannot change. But I want to tell you that when you explore the opportunity presenting itself to you, you will be able to make it. Take the case of Joseph that I have cited as an example, as a case study. The Bible says he was put in the prison by Potiphar. And in the prison, two people dreamt dreams. When, after he had interpreted their dreams unto them, he told the one with a better dream that when he gets off the prison yard, he should not forget him. It's an opportunity. Assuming he did not say that and leave the man to go after the man left the prison custody and he got to the palace, he forgot him completely. Now, when an occasion presents itself so that he be brought forward before the king again, if he had not uttered the word, it is a possibility that man too will not remember Joseph. But because he grasps the opportunity presented itself unto him, he told the man that when he gets up, because he is deeply assured within him that the vision will come to pass, that he must not forget him. When the occasion comes, the man remembered him. At the nick of time, at the right time, at the destined time that God wants him to remember Joseph, he remembered him. So, when opportunity presents itself on that occasion, do not miss that opportunity. Grasp the opportunity. You have been looking for a spouse for long, and you have been in friendship with a particular lady, and it seems as if the friendship is getting deep and deeper. Why not make use of the opportunity? You have been seeking for how to get accommodation for long, and suddenly God brings along your path a particular friend of yours whom you have known for years, and you see that his life is better than yours, and why can't you just ask him that? Talk to him in passing that you need so thing for so thing. He may not have it at that point in time, but he may have it later. He may rally around for you, and for all you know, he may provide the money for you at that point in time. Grasp the opportunity. Don't let the opportunity slip you by. When an opportunity presents itself, don't let the opportunity slip you by. Maybe you are seeking for admission for long, and you have not gotten one. And somebody comes along your path, there is a school in the land who offers scholarship that if you apply, it is a possibility that you'll be admitted. Why not try? Why not apply? With prayers, you may be admitted and given the scholarship too. Do not think that it is only those with higher grade who secure scholarship. Some people secure scholarship with low grade because they met with favor with those who control the institution. So do not miss opportunity when it presents itself. Do not for any reason miss opportunity when it presents itself. It is not begging. If the person does not do it, somebody else will do it. So Joseph tell the man that when you get out, do not forget me. Tell that friend of yours that he should not forget you. Tell that spouse of yours that he should not forget you. Tell that brother, sibling of yours, he needs not to forget you. Joseph made use of the opportunity. Now, what have I said so far? I have introduced this topic to you using the dimmed light that presents itself, making use of the dim light that you have seen. I have cited instances of dim light that we could see, that maybe your dim light is that you are only alive. Your parents, you are an orphan. You have nobody to support you anywhere, and you only know that you are only alive. You are not sure of what tomorrow holds. So maybe that is your own case. Your case may be bankruptcy. You are indebted to so many things. Your business has collapsed. It's not even paralyzed. It has collapsed absolutely, and you do not know the way out. Maybe that, but God can still make use of that limited thing you have in stock to make your business grow again. Somebody may just come and say, that thing that you have, can you supply it? And then the story will change. Your own may be academic, and you have no job, and you come across online business that can pay off, and you have been doing the online business. Now it has not paid off. Keep on doing it. That light will shine someday. It will get big someday, such that no one will be able to cover it. And when it becomes big that nobody can cover it again, I want to tell you, the blessing will be enormous. The blessing will silence your attackers. The blessing will silence the enemies. The blessing, of course, will overwhelm you. It will be too much for you, such that if you are in this part of the world, that people will begin to say, it is not only prayer that the brother or the sister was praying. He must have done something else, because that is the that is that the mindset of majority of people in this part developing world, when they see an outrageous blessing coming along somebody's path, they will say he must have done something secretly to make the blessing be as huge as that. So I am telling you that make use of that limited life. Now I now share with you about 10 points of how to make that limited life you have seen to become real. I said, speak positive words to that situation. Do not speak negative words. Remove negative words from your mouth and so speak positive words to your situation, to your life, to your condition, and to the thing you are passing through. Number two, and I said unto us that do not for any reason fight. Number three, make use of the opportunity that you have. Do not let that opportunity slip you by. Any slight opportunity, prayerfully make use of it. I said, go to the solitary place and commune with your God. Gather the pieces of your life together is another point I make mention, amongst other things. All this, if you do, you will be able to make, to magnify that limited light that you have with you. And while I sum everything up, I want you to know that salvation is vital. Salvation is important. Salvation is very, very important. The Bible says in the book of Mark, chapter 8, verse 36, that for what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? If you magnify the limited light, the dim light or the limited light you have seen to become big, and you make it in life, and you become popular, and you become rich, and you become known all over the world, even to the firmaments and the oceans, and you lose your soul in hellfire, it amounts to nothing, because everything you are possessed on earth will perish with the earth. But your soul is what matters unto God. God cherishes your soul so dearly. Therefore, he sent his son to die for you and I, so that we shall be saved. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son to the world, so that anyone who believes will not perish, but have eternal life. Your soul is very important unto God, irrespective of how you made it or not, of how big you are, of how wealthy you are, of this and that you possess on earth. God still wants you to be saved. Therefore, I am using this opportunity too to present Jesus to you afresh, that Jesus is all you need. Jesus is what you need. Jesus is whom you need to be able to make it to the kingdom of heaven. You need Jesus. You cannot get to the heavenly kingdom without Jesus. Our morals cannot take us to the kingdom of God. Our good deeds cannot take us to the kingdom of God. Building mosques, building churches, building temples here and there for people will not take us to the kingdom of God. What will take us to God's kingdom is Jesus Christ. Therefore, I sincerely implore you that you give your heart to Christ Jesus today. Give your life to him. You can give your life to him by repenting of your sins and coming to Jesus Christ. When you repent of your sins, when you repent of them, you renounce them and you turn a new leaf and you start to follow him wholeheartedly, then you will be saved. Then you invite Jesus to come into your life. Call him into your life. Ask him to help you and get a Bible and be reading Bible. Reading and studying your Bible very well. And then you will know more of God's ways. You will know more of God's ways. You will know more of God's purpose for your life. And then you will be able to get to the kingdom of God. For it shall profit a man nothing if he gains the whole earth and loses iso or aso in hellfire. It amounts to nothing. It is like a person on earth who died yesterday, and he was being given promotion today in his office. The new promotion amounts to nothing. It is like a person who died yesterday, and the message came from America or from London or from any other parts of the world that he has just won for himself so amount of dollars, so amounts of pound sterling for the works he has done years ago, maybe 10 years, maybe 2 years, or even maybe 6 months ago, or even if a month ago, and the person dies today, the money will be useless to him because he is already in the grave. And in fact, the family and the parents will be fighting for the money again. But if he is alive and receives the money will be useful to him. He will know that he has reaped out of the labor of his work, out of the labor of his hands, he has reaped. That is how heaven is. If you gain everything on earth and you lose your soul, you are just like that person who dies yesterday and the government promotes him today. You are just like that person who dies yesterday and Bill Gates or whosoever it is awards him a million dollar scholarship or something today. The money is useless to him. So giving your life to Jesus is all that matters. It is important. So making use of that dim light talks about how you can become, make it well on earth, become big, how you can overcome your failures and challenges. That is what that centers on. But having Christ is the cornerstone. Having Christ is the foundational basis. So if thou have Christ, thou possess everything, and all that I have shared will be easy for you to use, will be easy for you to use, and you will gain from thereby. So I sincerely implore that you give your life to Jesus Christ. Do not let this message slip you by. If you repent of your sins, confess your sins to God through Christ Jesus, do not go back to those sins again, and get thee a Bible and be reading. Get other Christian literatures and be reading. And you can subscribe to this YouTube channel to learn more of God, and of course to hear messages of the gospel. As you do all this, as you give your life to Christ, I pray that Jesus Christ will help your determination, and you will not slip back to sin again. Thank you. Till I come your way again, remain blessed.